Well, it was good, but I don't think it was as great as it was maybe a year before that. There'd been a lot of personnel changes and a few interruptions with nights off, so it was not the regular routine that we'd had for so many years. And, you know, I guess the Steel Pier didn't have the greatest acoustics either. So, well, it was still, it brought back a few memories because we'd played there before. So, in a sense, it was like a good place to spend my last days in the big bands. Joe and I were friends for a lot of years, and he traveled with me. And I would say he traveled with me for probably 3 or 3.5 years. And I'm sure that we traveled more than 100,000 miles together. And he was always a wonderful person to have next to me on all the driving. Plus my wife, of course, who traveled with me for about 4 years. Oh, his style was, I would say, close to perfection. I mean, he had a great sound and a great intonation, a great quality. And he never blew anything. You know, some trumpet players, trombone players, whatever, sometimes they just blast you out of the room and it wouldn't mean anything. But Joe had a mind where he knew what he was going to play, the next note or the next bar or the next 16 bars. And